Direct from downtown Main Street, it's Disney's House of Mouse.
Who's that knocking at the House of Mouse? We're all knocking at the House of Mouse. So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're all rocking at the House of Mouse. We're having a ball in the rock of the hall. So come on in, oh.
To the House of Mouse.
So come on in, the good times are all just about to begin. Step inside, we're gonna have some fun. There's plenty of room here for everyone.
The gang's all here and we're hanging out.
All this fun makes you jump and shout. Hey, little girl, I wanna dance with you.
We'll find so many things to do.
So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're having a ball
at the House of Mouse.
And now, America's Hostmaster General, Mickey Mouse.
Sorry, folks. We're running a bit late today.
Isn't everybody?
Anyway, we got a swell show.
Horace, when I said bring down the lights, I didn't mean literally.
Sorry.
Gosh, I can't seem to find the pizza menu, Mr. Hook. So, do you want deep dish or pan?
Bring me pan!
Oh, sorry, Cinderella. I overbooked. I should have a table for you after midnight. And they call me Sleeping Beauty.
Hang in there, folks. We're having some technical difficulties.
Oh, come on. Just look at all of these employee goof-ups we got here. From the sound of it, what this club needs is a big fat upgrade. So for you, I got my new House of Mouse version 2.0 boy.
Well, that's swell, Professor, but what's it do?
Oh, it does everything. And today, we're gonna use it to completely automate the House of Mouse with Vaughn Drake's patented audio automaton-o-matic robots. Observe, I hit the robo-hosting button, and then we're getting a robo-host.
Hey, welcome to the House of Mouse. Oh boy, gosh, swell.
He's as stiff as Mickey. Ha-cha-chard.
Ladies and gentlemen, the House of Mouse is now 38% more efficient.
Now that's an invention.
And not a string in sight.
Gosh, that robot's almost better than me.
Almost? He's amazing. Oh, I mean, yeah, almost.
Hey, folks, we got a great...
I asked for house dressing, not mouse dressing.
Ladies and gentlemen, House of Mouse proudly presents our spectacular cartoon presentation.
Hello there! Professor Vaughn Drake here. You know how everybody talks about the good old days? Well, you want to know something? Those good old days wasn't so good. What they should be talking about is the good future days. And this is where my latest brilliant invention comes in. Introducing the Vaughn Drake Future Viewer. Oh, beautiful. With this big thing here, the professor gonna show you how in the future all of your problems is gonna be solved. Here to helping the professor are three common everyday fellas with three common everyday problems. Wait a second, stop! Where's number one?
Sorry, got caught in traffic.
Woo-hoo. This is perfect for my first demonstration.
Headgear.
Bon voyage! In the future, you don't have to worry about the traffic. Because you're gonna have your own personalized flying saucer to unlock the gridlock.
Handsome.
Hey, in the future, accidents is a thing of the past. Whoa. Look at that! Safe and and sound. Well, there's other future ways that we're getting from point A to point B. Like the future bullet train. So, what do you think about that? The future really is some kind of futurific place. Common everyday fella number two, what's your common everyday problem? I see. Those bratty nephews of yours always getting you boiling mad.
Wow! Where are your boys?
They're right over there. In the future, we're gonna use kid power to run a whole world of kooky home electronics.
Electronics? Oh, boy!
You can have all kind of fun with your ultra-widescreen TV! Maybe you're taking a relaxing soak in the tubless tub. With my CompuCap, you can log on and go online straight from your brain. Tired? Why not catch a little shut-eye in your anti-gravity bed? Or you're gonna feel like you're sleeping on nothing. And best of all of this is powered by those rambunctious kiddies.
How? We're being used. What's that for?
So, what do you think about that, Donald? So, common fella number three, what's your complaint?
Well, I guess I'd like to spend more time with Minnie.
No problem with that.
Well, where's Minnie?
She's right there with you, on your wrist phone. Talk about handy.
Hello, Minnie?
Nope, yes again.
All wrist phones come equipped with wrist waiting.
Hang on, Goofy. Hello, Minnie?
You also got an ankle fax. Why not let your ankle answering machine get that?
Hi, I'm away from my ankle right now. Please leave a message.
Mickey, it's Minnie. Call me back.
Next, just ring up your honey on the big screen VidCom.
Hi, Minnie.
You're not supposed to see me like this. Oh, now you'll leave me for some curvy mouse droid.
Aw, you look like a million bucks. Besides, you know you're the only one for me.
Anything else, Mr. Mouse?
Huh?
Of course, in the future, you're going to have your own personal serving robot.
Robot? Boy, she's mad. Good thing she's not here.
With Insta-Transport, she's going to be there for your date instantly.
Now, Minnie.
What do you think about the future now?
Why don't you check it out for yourself, Professor?
Ooh, the Professor predicts a lot of fun in his future.
You know it, baby!
Oh, no.
Hey, Min, need any help?
No thanks, Mickey, for the fourth time.
I'm sorry. It's just that I'm feeling kind of second rate.
Oh, Mickey, that robot could never replace you. Oh, how sweet.
Hey there, mouses. Enjoying your little vacation time there?
Actually, Professor, I wanted to talk to you about that. The rest of the crew are still doing their jobs, and I kind of,
Say no more. I got Von Drake robots for everyone.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
welcome to the club.
Greetings. I am the new and improved Duald. Allow me to bid you welcome to the House of Mouse.
He ain't cranky like the real one, and I can understand him.
I'll have a table for you and Mr. Happily Ever After in a few.
Allow me to teleport you to a luxury booth, your highnesses.
Even Fairy Godmother couldn't do that.
Bring me my pizza, or you'll end up in Neverland!
One pan pizza with extra Tinkerbell peppers, and for dessert, Lost Boysenberry Pie. Bon appetit!
Oh, I better check tonight's show.
Unnecessary. I have booked the next 700 consecutive shows. You are unnecessary.
Those robots are really swell, huh?
Smart, too. That Metal Me is a regular genius.
They're all better than us.
Who needs us anyway?
Why?
Well, I don't know about you guys, but I'm not gonna be replaced.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
For our next entertainment phase. Hey, everybody! I'll introduce this next cartoon, because it stars... Actually, the next animated film features a mechanical house. Enjoy.
In a humble little house that needed some paint, lived a tired Mickey Mouse trying to sleep, but he can't. You see, the problems were plenty in this house that he had. The roof always creaked. And the drafts, they were bad. The furnace turned on with a clatter and clunk, making pipes sputter, steam, rattle, and plunk. With a slap and a bang, the shutters did slam. This noise, it continued to add nausea. He rolled and he tossed under his pillow and sheets. Poor Mickey was wishing the sounds, they would cease.
I can't take this racket another night longer. I thought that I could, but I couldn't be wronger.
He threw off his blankets and slunk to the sink.
Perhaps I'll feel better after a drink.
But the water came out in a way unexpected. It sprayed from the drain in his face, misdirected. He wiped off his mug in angry defeat.
That's the last straw. My decision's complete. I'm fed up with clanking, ker-slamming and squeaking, the whistling and knocking and roof always creaking.
Poor Mickey was irked, a bit peeved, you might say. His mind was made up that he must move away. So he gathered his things and emptied each drawer. The last thing he did was lock the front door. Then Pluto and he marched up the next street where new houses stood, all spiffy and neat. He found a nice dwelling that drew his attention with automatic devices of the latest invention.
This house is electric,
said the salesman with pride.
If you push this red button, you'll travel inside.
With the flick of a switch and the pull of a lever, the house, it transformed.
This is really quite clever.
The design's ergonomic for comfort, you see.
Grinned the salesman as he pushed buttons 1, 2, and 3.
The furniture folds right into the wall.
It makes a great shortcut into the hall.
This kitchen is sparkling.
It's synthetic steel. There's even a robot who can cook you a meal.
But how do the floors here all stay so clean?
Should dust ever settle, there's a vacuum machine.
Are there shutters that bang, slap, rattle, or slam?
Not a one, not a bit, not at all, my good man.
I'll take this new house,
said Mickey with zeal. After escrow and closing, the contract was sealed.
This newfangled house is now where I'll stay.
He then thanked the salesman and sent him away. So Mickey settled back in his modern recliner with buttons galore.
Ah, what could be finer?
Whatever he wanted was his right away. With a touch of a button, he got a snack tray. His chair, it reclined and rubbed his back so. Then on came some music and dimmed the lights low. Said Mickey with a yawn as he scratched on his head.
It's time for a bath, then I'll toddle to bed.
He pressed the red button and rolled across the floor. His chair went upstairs through the new bathroom door. With a splash and a splunk, the brushes did clean.
What a wonderful thing, this bathing machine.
Special arms then conveyed him off to his bed and tucked him in gently. Then a story was read. Mickey was cozy, all snuggled up tight. but he tossed and he turned as his thoughts did excite of buttons and switches and movable stairs, computer controls on reclining chairs.
There's so many things in this house with the play. I want to stay up. I'll just sleep in the day.
He leapt from his covers and slid past the clock. He flung open the door but discovered it blocked. There stood the robot, its finger it wagged. Before Mickey knew it, by a seat he was grabbed.
This just isn't right. I don't need a rest. I want to get up. Stop being a pest.
Mickey scampered away, heading straight for the door, but the robot was fast and stopped him once more.
Bedtime is fine, but this is my house. You're making me angry. Don't cheese off this mouse.
So he turned and he climbed out of the open window and snuck away quietly on tippy-tiptoe. But little did he think that out in the back, the robot was waiting for another attack.
Enough is enough. I'll take this no more. If you want to play rough, get ready for war. A bucket of water. That's just the right thing. When the robot comes in, I'll pull on the string.
Mickey readied his plan with his own little trap. The robot came in, and then, with a snap, the bucket tipped over, and water came out. It splashed and it soaked him completely throughout. He sparked and he fizzed that man made of steel. He jolted and bolted and began to unreel. Electricity surged in the house all about, zapping the circuits and shorting them out. Food from the fridge was flung in the air. It splattered and spattered in the poor mouse's hair. He ducked and he dodged, but he could not escape. The jelly that hit him was cherry, not grape. Back into the bath he was dragged very quick and repeatedly scrubbed with a soap on a stick. All sudsy and wet, Mickey Mouse tried to flee, but the vacuum was now on a house-cleaning spree. The hoses, they swung, they flailed, and they sucked. The brushes whooshed past, forcing Mickey to duck. He grabbed up a lamp and began to fight back. But right at that moment, the recliner attacked. Mechanical hands squeezed him up tight, but Mickey was valiant. He put up a fight. When things looked their bleakest and all hope seemed lost, Mickey picked up the chair and gave it a toss. It hit the controls and smashed them to bits. The buttons, they flashed and flickered in fits. Mickey spotted his chance to get safely away. He snatched up his dog and then he did say,
"This place is a monster, not what I'd call home."
He watched that new house shake, sputter, and groan. It fell with a crash. In less than a minute, he turned to his pup and said,
"Glad we weren't in it."
Dejected and sad, they both strode away. Mickey and Pluto with nowhere to stay. The rays of the morning added some light, greeting Mickey Mouse with a warm, friendly sight. A little wood house that needed some paint. It wasn't quite perfect, but still, it was quaint.
"Oh, we could stay here just for a while,"
said Mickey to Pluto with a wry little smile. Later that night, all warm in his bed, Mickey Mouse snuggled up as sleep came to his head. The furnace, it clanked, it rattled, it shocked. The shutters flew back, they slammed and knocked. The wind, it did whistle round the chimney, it moaned. But Mickey didn't stir, because he knew he was home.
House of Mouse patrons, please observe while I bust a move.
Now what was that? You know what? Enough already with the robots.
We want Mickey!
We want Mickey! We want Mickey! We want Mickey!
Oopsie! I told you they couldn't replace him, Mickey.
Okay, fellas, you know what to do. Guys, all you had to do was turn it off.
Oh, zippity-doo-dah, what are you doing? All my robots is going kooky in the noggin.
No more pan!
Duald says smoking in the House of Mouse is prohibited.
But I'm a fire-breathing dragon, for Pete's sake!
All right, crew, the robots have gone buggy on us, and I got a plan.
Robo-Mini, I thought I should warn you. 101 Dalmatians canceled, but there's still the Seven Dwarfs plus Aladdin and his 40 Thieves minus Hercules, Hunchback, and Pocahontas who also canceled. Got it? Cancellations do not compute.
Little Mermaid, I am a big fan.
Ariel, hi. Oh, you know, I adored you in the Little Mermaid. Groundbreaking stuff, really.
And if you reach 20,000
leagues under the sea, you definitely make a splash.
Let's see you match that, Metal Me.
But excuse me, do you know who I am? I'm a guardian spirit, Metalhead, okay? So you better move out of my way before I lose my temper.
Temper does not compute.
I'll show you a temper.
Crack, crack, crack.
There's only one robot left, and it's time I took back the show.
You go get him, Mickey.
Right, Metal Mickey, your show's over.
Incorrect.
There is nothing you can do that I cannot. Well, I can take a shower. Can you? Guess not. Catch you later.
Oh, my beautiful invention, reduced to scientific rubble. I hope that you learn something from all of this.
Sure. Technology can come and go, but you can't replace us.
What are you talking about? Of course you can. You see, this robot is gonna replace me.
All right, Robo-Professor. You know what to do with the old professor.
Maybe the professor should have thought this one through. Whoa!
That's it for today. See ya real soon, House of Mousetron.
Hi, everybody. It's me, Goofy. Did you know that the world's fastest dog is the Greyhound? Yep, some of them can run up to 41 miles an hour. Gosh, that's faster than I drive my car. Be sure not to say anything to Pluto, because he thinks he's the fastest dog around. I know, it'll be our secret. Goodbye now.